Friends, we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It's good to be with you again as we enter into the solemn season of Lent. And as we come with the sense of the world's sin, as we see events happening in Ukraine, I just want to say thank you to Ian on the organ, who played a Ukrainian piece just before the service began. So thank you for that link, Ian. We bring all that sin and sorrow of the world with us, recognizing our own sin as well. Coming together as God's family, we are aware of the times that we have failed to love God and to love our friends. With confidence that God is full of gentleness and compassion, we ask for God's forgiveness. Lord God Almighty, Creator of all life, of body and soul, we ask you to bless this water as we use it in faith. Forgive our sins and save us from all illness and the power of evil. Lord, in your mercy, give us living water, always springing up as a fountain of salvation. Free us, body and soul, from every danger, and admit us to your presence in purity of heart. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God our Father forgive us our sins and bring us to his table with his saints forever. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, whose Son fasted 40 days in the wilderness and was tempted as we are, yet without sin, give us grace to discipline ourselves in obedience to your Spirit. And as you know our weakness, so may we know your power to save. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We sit to listen to God's word.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. What does Scripture say? The word is near you, on your lips and in your heart. That is the word of faith that we proclaim. Because if you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. The scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jew and Greek. The same Lord is Lord of all and is generous to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit in the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. He ate nothing at all during those days, and when they were over, he was famished. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become a loaf of bread." Jesus answered him, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone." Then the devil led him up and showed him in an instant all the kingdoms of the world. And the devil said to him, "To you I will give their glory and all this authority, for it has been given over to me, and I give it to anyone I please. If you then will worship me, it will all be yours." Jesus answered him, "It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil took him to Jerusalem and placed him on the pinnacle of the temple, saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you to protect you, and on their hands they will bear you up so that you will not dash your foot against a stone." Jesus answered him, "It is said, do not put the Lord your God to the test." When the devil had finished every test, he departed from him until an opportune time. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. It was Oscar Wilde who famously said, "I can resist anything except temptation." And on this first Sunday of Lent, we recall in that scripture reading we've just heard how Jesus was led into the wilderness for 40 days by the Spirit of God. It was God's will that Jesus should be in the wilderness. But while there, the devil tempts him. And we often think of those three temptations: to turn stone into bread, to worship the devil and receive all the authority and glory of the nations that the devil shows him, and then to test God by throwing himself off the pinnacle of the temple. In each of those occasions, in those temptations, Jesus rebukes the devil with a word of scripture. But there is perhaps a fourth and more subtle temptation that underlies those three that we commonly think of at this time. Jesus has just been baptized in the River Jordan by John the Baptist. It's the beginning of his public ministry. And as Jesus comes up out of the water, so we're told by Luke, Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. But there, at the Jordan River, as Jesus begins his public ministry, and as John plunges him beneath the waters of the Jordan, Jesus rises up and hears the voice of God. "You are my son, my beloved. With you I am well pleased." And as Jesus goes into the wilderness, led by the Spirit, to try and determine what this means for him, so the devil sees his opportunity and brings those temptations to him. But the more subtle temptation that lies behind each of them are those words that the devil uses: "If you are the Son of God." So what the devil is tempting Jesus to do is to deny that experience and that voice that he's had at the Jordan River. "If you are the Son of God." But Jesus will not abuse that authority and power and relationship that he has with God his Father. And so he rebukes the devil and puts him in his place. Luke, in that ending of our gospel reading today, says the devil left him until an opportune time. And we know that Jesus was tempted throughout his life and ministry. The writer to the Hebrews in chapter 4 tells us that Jesus was in every way tempted as we are, yet without sin. And when Jesus comes to the end of his life and hangs on the cross, what do we hear but the subtle voice of the devil talking to him again? As one of the thieves crucified with him says, "If you are the Son of God, save yourself and us." And then from the crowd, "If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross now and we will believe you." The devil never stopped tempting Jesus. And when we will say in a moment in the words of the Creed, "He was made man," the writers of the New Testament scriptures try to make it plain to us that in every way he knew what we are like as human beings. He is even tempted as we are, yet without sin. tempted as we are. When you were baptized and the priest made the sign of the cross on your forehead, he would have used words such as, "Christ claims you for his own. You belong to God. You are a child of God. Just as Jesus was God's son, so you are a son or daughter of the God who claimed you at your baptism." And as a child of God, you are loved by God. Black or white, Jew or Greek, male or female, gay or straight, it doesn't matter. There are no distinctions made by God, because as a child of God, claimed by God at your baptism, God bestows on you his unending love. And as the voice said to Jesus, "With you I am well pleased." We need, in our own discipleship, as we follow Christ, this Christ who claims us for his own, we need to work out how we can please God in our lives. And Lent is given to us so that we can examine our lives in the light of that hope and that promise that we are given, that we are children of God, loved by God. How can we make God pleased with us? And so we have this season of Lent to enter into. We are tempted by the devil, you and I. He tries to undermine the very fact that we belong to God, claimed by him in the power of Christ's cross, and loved by him unconditionally and everlastingly. Don't let anybody, any other voice, tell you otherwise. That's your dignity as a human being made in God's image. That's your dignity as a child of God claimed at baptism as belonging to Christ. How we live out that responsibility and that dignity is up to each one of us in the opportunities of life that God gives us. But we pray that through us, God will indeed be honored, and with us, he will be well pleased. Amen. So let's stand to affirm our faith in Christ. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who's spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray.
As children of our Heavenly Father, who knows us so well and loves us completely, let us pray. Father, knowing our weakness in the face of temptation, we ask for your strength and protection, so that although we may falter at times, you will be there to guide us through any difficult times. We pray for all those who are fighting temptation and finding it difficult to resist. We ask you to help them see clearly and choose the right path for the benefits of their well-being. Please hear our prayer and lead us not into temptation. We pray for our church, our ministers and church officers, and especially Father Steve, who patiently waits to return to office, and a continued prayer for the welfare of those we love and our families, our community, schools, university, and places of commerce in our garden quarter. We pray for our government in their difficult decisions and ask for strength to world leaders in their efforts to work together for the benefit of our planet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer
and deliver us from evil. We pray for those in our church family at this time, namely Peter Johnson, Rosina Crocombe, John and Susie Platt, Father Hugh and Janet, Bill and Barbara Cowell, Hazel Williams, Pat and Sarah Potbury, Margaret Alloy, Nora Clues, Darren, Sue, Stephen, Brian and Kate, Alison, and Edith. Let us observe a quiet moment for those near and dear to us and offer a private prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we stand alongside all those who are suffering at this time, especially the Ukrainians whose lives are in chaos and utter despair. We pray for an end to this mindless invasion and to guide all the Russian perpetrators to consider their actions and restore peace to the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have been killed in conflicts around the world, those who are dying due to illness and starvation, and we pray for those who have passed through death and see you face to face, that they may be reassured with your everlasting peace. Father, we thank you that no one is beyond the limits of your love or forgiveness for any weaknesses we have shown in our lives. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers. For the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We do not presume
to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather from, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Morning. First of all, thank you everybody that supported pancakes. We have made a profit. I haven't got actual numbers yet. We've had a pretty hectic week and I haven't got around to doing the stock take of the bar, but we have made a profit. Most things are on your list. Just a pre-warning again about next week, about the traffic because of the marathon. It's not on your list because we've only decided this morning that on March the 16th, it's a Wednesday, we're going to hold a light Lenten lunch and the profits from that will go to the Ukraine. It will be on your notice sheets by next week. Okay, so that's the 16th of March for your diaries. I think that's the time. Oh, sorry. The time is 12 till 2. Okay, thank you.
Let's stand to share the peace. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. So, my sisters and my brothers, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's greet those around us with a sign of peace. Peace be with you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
We must give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and Everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son. For in these 40 days, you lead us into a desert of repentance, that through a pilgrimage of prayer and discipline, we may grow in grace and learn to be your people once again. Through fasting, prayer, and acts of service, you bring us back to your generous heart. Through study of your holy word, you open our eyes to your presence in the world and free our hands to welcome others into the radiant splendor of your love. As we prepare to celebrate the Easter feast with joyful hearts and minds, we bless you for your mercy and join with saints and angels forever praising you and singing, Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these your gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. And so, Father, calling to mind Christ's death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Thomas of Canterbury, St. Oswald, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
For we are many, we are one body, because we all share.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. May the Lord Jesus bless you and fill your heart with his joy, gladness, and peace. Amen.
the body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Body of Christ, sorry.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. May our Lord Jesus bless you and fill you with joy and gladness. Amen. The body of Christ. A lot there, actually. Thank you. Let us pray. Lord God, you have renewed us with the living bread from heaven. By it you nourish our faith, increase our hope, and strengthen our love. Teach us always to hunger for him who is the true and living bread, and enable us to live by every word that proceeds from out of your mouth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Together in thanksgiving we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Days and 40 nights thou wast fasting in the wild. 40 days and 40 nights tempted and yet undefiled.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.